What's up, guys? It's Jay's Day here, and we are skating currently
some Vans half cabs.
So I'm gonna let you guys know what they skate like nowadays with the new Vans formula, with the little split at the back and all that. Let you know how much they changed from the last pair I had. And yeah, hopefully we get some nice tricks today.
I'm like, whoa there, slim thing looking with the long hair. Yeah, wait, what? Yeah, I'm like, whoa there, white boy drip like I'm Ric Flair. Yes, sir. Yes, I'm like, whoa there, I ain't seen you, do you go here? Yeah. And yes, I'm like, whoa there, let me get your number off the phone there.
Like, why you gotta go there? I've been dripping ice like it's snow here. They don't call the ice, it's a coaster. Put a check out of 9 if you go there. Ain't really got time for the bro tears. Plain Jane, that's my bitch. Blue hood ass looking like a crook. Call my man Wicks, it's a whole drip.
I walk in, I say no, what's up? Yeah, you look like Selena and Judge. My demeanor is meaner, I'm up. Does that mean in the scene that I'm up?
I'm sipping, I'm leaning, no stuff. I'm dripping, you dreaming, good love. My brother, we broke from the mud. We chasing no choices with love.
Tell my mama that I made it. Tell my daddy that I made it. Also, one congratulations. Haven't heard it in a minute.
Haven't seen you in a minute. Stacking money to the ceiling.
Hold up, Peter Pike, the weed of flyers.
Oh, yeah.
Pinky ring causing nightmares.
Hell nah. I see the money, yes, I got it. Tell your girl she gotta stop it. She ride away like Kawasaki. I die for the gang, kamikaze.
Dress the sun up from the toe. Back then, they didn't know us. Messed around and we done blowed up.
Blown up, popping like coronas. Came a long way from Tacoma. Now I'm whipping it around.
All right, so I have the Vans half cab with the new classic formula. I have a lot of things to say about it, so let's hop right on in. So this shoe is actually a really good looking shoe. That sky blue is really starting to pop out now that it's more dirty. And I don't know, I've always been a fan of the look of the half cab, so this is no exception. I'm glad that the classic look hasn't changed even with the new formula. And what that new formula really is that there's a tiny splint towards the heel of the shoe. It's a little bit more stable. The foxing tape is more updated, so it grips a little bit more and it lasts a little bit longer. And I can tell you right now, I can feel all three of those things in the shoe. So with that being said, Vans is still their classic Van. It's still the same amount of impact for the most part. It takes a little bit more, but you're getting a lot more skateability out of it, if that makes any sense. So this shoe is a mostly suede upper with canvas in that breathable area on that side panel, and then towards the top of your heel collar. Outside of that, there's really no more canvas around the rest of the shoe. Your tongue is also made of canvas too. It helps it be breathable. It helps it with the padding as well and just getting some breathability towards the tongue of your shoe. The rest of it is made of suede. So the only concern I do have, which really isn't a concern for me because my feet are gonna get hot anyway, but as we go through the summer here in Arizona, I'm pretty sure my feet are gonna get hot a lot faster than if I were to have something with knitting or more canvas in it. But I'll sacrifice my feet getting hot to make sure that I have really good durability. When it comes to durability, this shoe definitely does stand out when it comes to Vans because you have multiple layers of suede, especially in that kickflip area. That kickflip area has a nice like upper layer of suede that goes around your entire kickflip area on the toe box, and then you're backed up by the suede of the ollie area, and then backed up by one extra layer of suede, and then you have Duracap. So that's literally four different layers of durability. I'm gonna put this shoe at a 4 out of 5 for durability because I don't know exactly how it's gonna last over a long period of time, but I do know starting off and just looking at the way the shoe is placed, I could definitely put this shoe at a 4 out of 5 for sure when it comes to durability. Now that foxing tape is updated to last a little bit longer than your average pair of half cabs without that Skate Classic tag on it. And I will say I can automatically feel the difference in stability versus the first pair I ever reviewed some years back of half cabs. And I will say also that I don't have as hard of a time kick flipping in this shoe. It is a little bit sharper than the original pairs I had, which is really, really sick because it makes it easier for me to kick flip. I'm gonna put your flick area at a solid 4 out of 5 because of that shape, because of the way the Skate Classics are now made and that foxing tape is made. It makes it a little bit easier to roll off the side and get that flick while also giving you a nice grippy flick. As you guys saw with that kickflip over the rail I did, I mean, that speaks for itself. The shoe does grip your flick. When it comes to that side panel, that heel flip area, all that good stuff, your area of stability in the shoe, I'm gonna put that at a 4 as well. I do feel like it's a lot harder to shift from side to side in the shoe. So whatever they did with that splint, wherever it's at in the shoe, I'm pretty sure it's towards the heel of the shoe, but I've never cut open a pair of Skate Classics to figure out where exactly it's at. Wherever it is in the shoe though, it's definitely doing its work towards the heel because it is a lot harder to shift from side to side in your heel area, which means that it should be a lot harder to roll your ankle unless you roll it toe side, which it's a little bit harder to protect yourself toe side from ankle rolls because then you have a vulcanized shoe or a hybrid, then that toe area is made to be as completely flexible and movable as possible, which means that you're going to be more susceptible to rolling towards the toe, which could lead to high ankle rolls. So be careful with the way that you do put down your foot. If you do put down your foot toe side, you want to put it down as firm as possible to avoid those high ankle rolls from just having your toe up like that and going over. Outside of that, if you were to just have your foot flat, it's going to be a lot harder to roll over to the side because of the way that Vans structurally made the half cab with that Skate Classic formula. I'm putting stability at a 4, and we're going to figure out if it stays at that, goes higher or goes lower as we skate the shoe more. I'm going to put comfortability at a 3.5 in this shoe because the tongue centering straps on the inside do hold the tongue down on top of your foot, and going more towards the toe area, like right by the toe box, it's a little bit uncomfortable. So as I break in the shoe, it's loosening up more, but as I started in this shoe, it did feel very uncomfortable feeling that feeling. So that is something I will say look out for if you're looking for comfort in this shoe while you're skating. The tongue centering straps are gonna really hold down your tongue. If you wanted to, you could cut the tongue centering straps. You still won't have to worry about your tongue going too far off to the side because of how fat the tongue is made in the half cabs. But I will say when you do cut the tongue centering straps, it's going to be harder to wear the shoe loose like how I wear them. So that will be your fair warning. The grip of the shoe is your standard Vans waffle outsole. I honestly stand by it. I put it at a 4.5 out of 5. This is honestly some of the grippiest soled shoes I've ever had. But I will say that the ones that the Rowans use are the most grippy. The 6 stick that they use on that waffle outsole literally makes it that much grippier. And it's probably the grippiest outsole I've ever had in the Rowans. But the half cabs are not too far from it. Not using the 6 stick in the sole, it's still the standard waffle outsole. It grips really, really well. We're going to see how long that grip lasts. If it stays at a 4.5, if it goes any higher over time, or if it just drops off to a 1. We don't know. We're going to figure out because the new formula does promise some new and improved things. Outside of that, this is a pretty standard pair of Vans. Your Vans Skate Classics, this is the formula that they're using moving forward. So you can expect that out of all of your Vans half cabs going forward, your half cab pros, keep that in mind, or your skate half cabs, are calling it skate half cabs now. So when you go to the Vans store, check out a pair of half cabs if you're interested in skating that Skate Classic formula and feeling all the new features that they've added to their Vans. If you guys enjoyed this shoe review, make sure you hit that like button. And if you guys are not subscribed, hit that subscribe button. I have a lot more content coming for you very, very soon. So you're gonna wanna be subscribed. You're gonna wanna check in because I got some really sick stuff on the way. That's it. It's Jay's day. Make today your day. Go skate, go have a good time. And I'll catch you guys in the next video. Peace out.